Sage Marie Hawkins had a rough start in life. When it was time for Sage to enter the world, she was breached position and the umbilical cord was wrapped around her neck. After such a traumatic birth, there was plenty of rejoicing when Sage finally went home. But it wasn't the end of her challenges. As a baby, Sage remained smaller than other infants her age. She wasn't very active, and she didn't start rolling over or crawling when other babies did. Instead, she began standing very early. Standing at such a young age was due to excessive stiffness in her legs, a sign of a disability. It was soon learned that Sage has severe cerebral palsy.
When I found out, I felt that I had done something wrong, that it was something that I did. When I first took Sage to the rehabilitation center, we were very nervous because we did not know what to expect. After they got her assessed, they admitted her in for therapy, and they gave us information and let us know what kind of goals we can work on and what we would need to do to reach those goals for Sage to achieve, and really put me at ease, and they were wonderful with the whole process. After about a year of Sage having therapy, I had a change in job locations, and we moved to St. Louis for about 6 months where she wasn't receiving any therapy at all. And when we moved back to Evansville, the rehabilitation center took her back as if we had never left.
During the first few years of Sage's life, her mom faced all these challenges as a single parent. Then a very special person came into the picture. Someone to share the challenges and the joys with Danette and Sage.
I had absolutely no reservations whatsoever about making a commitment to both of them. And it's been a journey. It's been real interesting. We've learned a lot from each other. Danette swears that a lot of her sense of humor and strange behavior are all my fault. But I think it could go the other way as well. But it's been a good time. It's like I say, it's been a learning experience, but it's been wonderful.
I think it takes a great man to be able to not only bring on an extra family as far as a wife and two kids already, but to have someone that's involved with disabilities and not even give it a second thought.
I've been to many of the therapy sessions with Sage at the Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center, and I've watched her over the years progress a great deal.
When I see Ryan with Sage at therapy, it makes me feel complete to know that there is someone else within our family unit that supports Sage in her progress.
I believe that the Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center staff are all first-rate human beings, without exception.
Sage is now 9 years old and continues receiving therapy at the Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center every week.
Sage and I are walking in a device that helps support her so she doesn't have to take all of her weight on her legs, and can really concentrate on keeping her head up, can concentrate on taking nice steps as compared to her legs crossing over and tripping herself. Because of the cerebral palsy, Sage's muscles tend to be very stiff or else very loose. So with the walking system, she can concentrate on taking steps, allowing her muscles to relax. Sage is a sweetheart. She is motivated, she's fun, she's always in a good mood, she's always happy.
Since she's been going all these years, she's made several improvements in her physical abilities. She's gained awesome trunk control, her balance has improved, she's standing on her feet, and she's even beginning to walk a little bit more with assistance.
Thanks to her therapies at the Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center, Sage is gaining an independence, and she's thriving in public school. She successfully participates in all the activities alongside her fourth grade classmates at Stockwell Elementary in Evansville.
Sage, are you finished?
Awesome.
Good job.
Sage's best friend, Katie Blackwell, attends Stockwell School too, where she's in the fifth grade. They both have smiles that light up a room, and both are advocates for kids with disabilities. When she was just 3 years old, Katie and her mom helped raise awareness of the need for daycare for children with special needs. Their video appeal led to the opening of Milestones, the Easter Seals Child Development Center. Sage saw a need for a wheelchair-accessible drinking fountain at her school. She lobbied tirelessly until she achieved her goal, and other students will benefit from her determination for years to come.
Okay, Sage, ready?
Sage and Katie continue receiving physical, occupational, and speech therapy at the Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center.
By playing what we call volleyball, Sage and Katie are working on upper body strength, more upper body control with both of their arms, as well as trying to use both arms together in a more coordinated movement to help them with their everyday skills such as bathing and dressing and feeding themselves.
Sage and Katie continue their close friendship outside school and the rehabilitation center. Just like any other girls, they love to laugh, listen to music, share secrets, have slumber parties, and just have fun.
I would wish that everybody could have the chance to truly live life and experience everything. As her father, I will try and do everything that I can to see that that happens.
20 years from now, I think that she could really do great things with herself because she is so persistent with everything, and she has such a huge heart. I think she can achieve great things. I love her, and I want to thank her for all the inspiration that she has been to me.